And we're back.
Welcome back.
It's World of X Games, Brando and Jack. And we're still in the midst of previewing Saturday. It's our heaviest event day of the weekend at X Games Aspen 2020. We're now on to Saturday evening. The lights have been turned on, Jackie.
The lights turn off. Sorry, the lights turn on and the snow bike lights turn on. Sorry about
that. That's right, snow bike cross.
Snow bike cross. It's between the two, the battle of the Canadian friends, Brock Hoyer and Cody Matichuk. Matichuk, two-time defending snow bike cross champ. While Hoyer has medaled all three times, the discipline has been contested at X Games, and he's got a medal of each color. And if I remember correctly last year, Matichuk was the number one qualifier, but out of nowhere, Jesse Kirchmeier, for the majority of the final, was in first, and there were three laps to go. You know what happened?
It was a pass. Said, I called it the pass.
See you later.
Yeah.
The Ricky Bobby.
Yeah, it was a little shake and bake.
Got
and slung shot past him to take the win.
Yeah, right.
It was amazing.
So now Matichuk's going for that three-peat, but can Brock Hoyer take him down? Ooh, we
Yeah, it's
out.
Really, it's kind of our lone racing event, right? So all eyes are on that one. I always love watching snow bike cross, so that's rad. Moving on, women's ski superpipe. And we talked about her in Big Air.
Kelly Sildaru.
Kelly Sildaru, come on!
Honestly, like she went into Aspen last year with pretty much no practice. She was just like, you know what? I'm just gonna go try it out. You know, I'm already doing slopestyle. I'm doing Big Air. Let's see if I can put something down in the pipe. And she does, and gets a silver.
Yeah, it was a great battle between she and Cassie Sharp. And we're really happy for Cassie and certainly the Sharp family. One of the best winter sports families there are, along with brother Darcy, but Cassie just crushes it in that pipe. But again, keep your eyes on Kelly Sildaru as she tries to go 2 years in a row of the three-peat.
I hope she wins all three. That would be incredible.
And then we move on to men's snowboard Big Air. We love to talk about rivalries.
Yes, of course we do.
And for the last few years, this one has really been about Maxence Perreault versus Mark McMorris. Now, we did not have Max last year, as we said, his battle with cancer. What a warrior Max is to get through this and
so resilient.
Got ready for Big Air at X Games Norway last year. Just him literally being 2 months removed from chemo is impressive in and of itself to just say, hey, I want to get out there and compete. And his first event back, Jack.
I got the chills, Brando.
He wins gold.
I mean, could you imagine what that's like for him to be sitting on the hospital bed going through 12 rounds of chemo, leaving the hospital 2 months later, standing on the top of the podium? I have so much respect. What an inspirational story. And hopefully that just inspires you to be resilient with no matter what you're going through. But back to the competition, back to the rivalry with Mark McMorris. What's it gonna be like?
Yeah, this one's gonna be really interesting. Now, Max, even with that year off in Aspen, or I should say that event off, he still holds the all-time record for most gold medals and just most medals in the history of Big Air at X Games. Mark is right behind him, he has 7. Max Perreault has 8. This is one that Mark has certainly won before. He's absolutely more known for his distinguished career in slopestyle. But I just feel like, as you said before, in slopestyle, given the recent passing of Jake Burton Carpenter, I think this is going to be a really emotional X Games, especially for Mark McMorris, certainly the entire snowboarding community,
Absolutely.
Because Jake's legacy lives on with everyone.
Yep.
But I think this is going to be a really special one for Mark. And as we said before, he's got the chance to pass Shaun White for most medals all time. And if he's going to do it, he's going to need a win in this event, or at least a podium performance.
Yep. And it's going to be tough, man. The level, it's not even just Max and Mark. I mean, who else do we have? It's literally
Sven Torgren, Yuki Kodono, Chris Corning, and
it's anybody's ball game out there.
Well, so, and we've seen it before, right? Because it's like, we knew when guys have had quads, we've seen quads landed, but that doesn't necessarily guarantee victory because you got to do it in a couple of different directions.
You got to go both ways. You got to spin to the left. You got to spin to the right. You got to flip upside down at least 4 times and then spin at least 4 more. So the level is just mind blowing.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. And I think, you know, Mark, we know when Mark's got his 16s locked in, how good that can be. But if for whatever reason, he's not landing it. Sometimes you can just sneak through and grab a victory.
Yep, it's going to be a fun one to watch. And another fun one to watch is going to be the women's snowboard superpipe.
Oh, yes. So
we talk about Chloe Kim.
We have to mention Chloe.
We're talking about
arguably our biggest star at X Games is already announced that she's taking the year off. She's studying. She's in college right now.
Princeton.
She's a freshman at an Ivy League. And she's doing something unprecedented, Jack, because we've had athletes before do the dual role where they compete and also go to school. Very rarely do we have an athlete in their absolute prime who is a superstar among superstars doing what Chloe Kim is doing right now.
Just completely walking away. I mean, that'd be like Michael Jordan just being like, you know what, I'm not going to play this season.
Well, he did do that to go play baseball. But then came back
and was himself.
But that is what Chloe's saying, because Chloe has made it very clear. I'm not retiring. I'm just taking this year off to focus on school. But the question now becomes, who is going to lead that change? Because not only was Chloe winning, she was pushing the progression.
She was.
Who's it going to be?
I think it's going to be Maddie Mastro. Watching her last year at the Burton US Open, she pulled off a double crippler perfectly.
Yep. First time.
And first time. And even without that, I mean, as you're watching on the screen, this is Maddie Mastro. She is so good and so consistent and has such good style. And so now that Chloe is going to be head down in her books, I think it's Maddie Mastro's.
Yeah, we've talked about Maddie for the last few winters about can she break through. And she's certainly made some noise in other contests, but this has been such a Chloe Kim dominated event. And certainly before that, it was Kelly Clark forever. So this is really uncharted territory for this field. Who's going to pick up the mantle with Chloe Kim out of the mix? I think we both expect it to be Maddie Mastro.
What goes through your mind if you're Maddie Mastro and you just hear the news that Chloe Kim is taking the year off?
Yeah.
Celebration, or are you bummed because you don't have the person at the top to
go after? Well, you know, and Maddie and Chloe are good friends, certainly, but Maddie's a competitor. I mean, you watch her set up before every run. She visualizes everything.
Does the clap.
Yep. Right. So I think this is going to be an opportunity that she's going to take advantage of. And she wanted to bring that trick to Aspen. Conditions didn't allow it. We certainly got to see it at the Burton US Open last year. But if she can put it down on the biggest stage in the world, on the super pipe in Aspen, look out.
We're rooting for you. We're rooting for you. And I'll be rooting for some music to close out Saturday night. Alesso.
Oh my gosh.
Swedish pop DJ galore.
Legend.
It's going to be insane.
It's crazy to me Alesso's finally playing Aspen.
I know.
What's going on?
He's really fit the bill, you know, with Kygo and the Chainsmokers and everything. So Saturday night, what the kids are saying, it's going to be lit.
Yeah, that's usually where we lose Jack and we're on our text thread and we're like, where's Jack? And
then we just see
on his Instagram stories and the X Games Instagram stories.
Alesso,
it's just like Jack front row in front of the Geico Music Stage.
It's lit. Join me Saturday night.
Okay, so we're 3 days in here at X Games Aspen. When we come back Sunday, fun day, we preview our fourth and final day at Buttermilk. Stick around, won't you?